Hi, this is Carrie with Learn DaVinci Resolve, and today I'm going to show you how I did it. What are we going to look at? We're going to look at this logo treatment that I did for a real estate shoot that I just finished up. And I had his logo, and I'm like, just needs a little something. So let's take a look at what we actually got. So that's the finished product. We started with a very simple graphic, put it into Fusion, added a Milky Way background, then a little lens flare that follows along the shape of the graphic, a spinning earth, and that house fading in from the background to really show that this is a real estate agent's site or video. So let's take a look into Fusion and see how we pulled this all off. All right, so you saw the finished product. Now let's put it all together. We're going to start, we'll go with a generator, a Fusion composition. We're going to drag that onto the timeline. And I want this thing to be 7 seconds long. So make it right there at 7 seconds. And now to go into Fusion. Oops, there we go. All right, we're in Fusion, we've got our media out, and we need to start assembling things. First thing we're gonna do is let's bring in our logo, and I'm gonna go F2 and call this logo, and we're gonna put this on an image plane, and might as well get the rest of the pieces in here. We need a merge 3D node, merge 3D, and then we're going to need a render node. Can't type tonight. Render 3D, and then that will go into our media out. All right, so far so good. And to kind of visualize everything, we're going to need a camera 3D. So we'll put that in place along with the merge 3D. And let's kind of see where things are. Whoops. We need to pull that camera back so it's in view. I'll put the media out into our left, and I'll put our camera over in the right, and I'm just going to pull the camera back until I have the logo where I want it. Okay, now we have our basic 3D scene here. I think I'm going to go ahead and pull the camera back a little more. And I need to bring the logo up or closer to the camera. So let me grab that, and now I'll bring the camera or the logo closer to the camera. Now, why am I doing this? This is going to be so that I can start stacking different image planes together. I'm going to need the Milky Way Galaxy one behind it, and I'm going to need the picture of the house in front of that, but behind the logo. So I need to kind of stack these a little bit. All right, so let's go ahead and bring in our Milky Way. So I'll go F2, and I'll just call this stars. Again, we're going to go put that on an image plane and connect that to our merge 3D. All right, now it's not quite the right size for what I'm working on, so I'm going to need to scale this up. And I'll go to my scale tool, and I'll just scale that guy up a little bit. And that's going to be the furthest one, so I'm going to push that back a little bit, and I'll just go ahead and scale it back up so it fits. Okay, making progress here. Now, one of the things I do need to make sure I do is go into my 3D options. I'm just right-clicking on this camera one and go lighting and shadows. And on my render 3D node, I want to make sure I turn on lighting and shadows, but this isn't going to do much good at the moment because I don't have a light. So what kind of light do we need? Well, there's only one kind of light that casts shadows, and that's a spotlight. So let me bring this into play here, connect that to the merge 3D. All right, we can kind of see it there. Oops, and I'm going to pull that light back. And I'm gonna want to do some animation on this, so I'm gonna just kind of tweak it here just a little bit to get us started. And I'm gonna put that on our y-axis. And I am gonna turn the intensity down a bit. So I do want the color of that logo to come in, and I'll make the cone angle a little bit bigger. Okay, so far so good. And but now you see this light is affecting that star background. I definitely don't want that. So I'm going to go to my image plane over here, go up to my materials, and I'm going to turn off lighting and shadows on that so the light does not affect that background. Okay, we've got that going there. Now let's throw in our earth. So to do that, I'm going to come up here to my shape 3Ds. I don't want to do it that way. I want to make sure nothing's selected. And I'll drop a shape 3D in here and I'll connect that to my merge node. And we have a square. Well, I'm going to go up here to my properties and make sure I'm under controls and change that to a sphere. Okay, so far so good. Change my radius down quite a bit there. Oh, maybe right in there. It's gonna look good. And I'll put that into position where I want it. And maybe a little higher. Okay, not too shabby there. And I've got my earth graphic here. So I'm going to drag that into place and put that onto that shape. Oh, look at that. I've got an earth going. I'm going to make sure I name this one. This is earth. And we want to spin this earth. And to do that, if we notice our Y plane here, and for it to go kind of the direction I want, correct or not. Okay, I know it should go one way, but it's going to look better going the other way. That's going into the negatives. Keep that in mind. Now I'm going to hit equals on the y-axis. So I go into expressions and I'm going to do time times, let's try 2. That should give us a good spin on there. All right, now the earth is moving. It's moving in the right direction. Everything's looking good. If I wanted to rotate that in the opposite direction, I would do time times negative 2, and that would reverse. Oops, gotta hit enter there. That would reverse the direction. But we do want it to go east to west, so that's going to be time times 2. And now we have our east to west rotation on there. Okay, so far so good. And okay, what was the next thing that we wanted to do here? Well, we want to fade in that other image, the image of the house. So I'm going to drop that image in place, hit F2. I'll call this house. And that needs to go on an image plane. So a lot of the same things here to get where we want to go. Put that on the merge node. And let me put that over here. And I'm going to make sure that is in front of my stars. I can check that by going to my merge, and I can see the position of things if I select that image one, so I can see that I just wanted just in front of it. Okay, we'll put the media out back there so we can see what we're doing. Go to our image plane, and again, I need to scale this up. And I just want it to fit. Okay, now again, I don't want this to be affected by the light. I'm going to zoom that out just a hair. Okay. So make sure I'm on my image plane, go to my materials, turn off lighting and shadows on that. All right, now we have our house in place and I want to fade that in. So I'm going to need to do some keyframing and I want it to, I think I'm going to want it to start fading in. Let's see, we have 167 frames. I want it to be probably around frame 70. I want it to really, well, let's try 55. Okay, that's where I'm gonna kick it in here. So my opacity, I'm gonna make sure I select keyframe and turn that all the way down. And I want that to come in and be full. Let's do it at frame 100. Okay, so now we're gonna have this fade. It's gonna come into place. A nice fast machine would really help on this, but we can see what we're doing. Okay, so now we've got the home fading into place. Next piece is going to be to animate that spotlight. So I've got my spotlight down here and go to make sure I'm on my transform section. And I'm gonna play around with a couple things here. So I want it kind of this highlight to go across it, but I don't want to lose any of it. So let's see, I can go over here to my spotlight. If I kick my intensity up, not really doing what I want, my cone angle, I can make bigger, my drop off. Let's try taking the cone angle down a little bit more and see the more I adjust that drop off, kind of the softer it is. I think that'll work. So I have kind of a shadow going on over there. I want to make sure I'm on the first frame and onto my transform. Now I'm only changing the Y axis, right? Oh, nope. Oh, I should be on rotation. Wrong group here. I'm only changing the Y axis. So I've got it all the way to the left. Make sure I have a keyframe, go all the way to the right, and adjust it just to where the beginning of that kind of starts to fade out a little bit. So now we're going to have this light kind of wipe across the screen. Just kind of scrub it so we can see, if you see the light over here in the first monitor, you can kind of see what it's doing. It's not that intense of an effect. Maybe if I turn the intensity down a little bit, I have more of the color there, and we'll bounce to the end. Okay, I want it to be subtle. I don't want it to be overly done. Okay, so what have we got here? We've got our Earth, it's spinning. We have our logo, it's fading. The background is fading over to the house. And now we have the light kind of washing across the logo. Now we need to add the lens flare. And this kind of took me a little bit to figure out how I wanted to do it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the edit tab. Ooh, that's really big. And go fit. Go to my effects library. Let me get rid of the media pool. I'll go to my effects library to open effects and go to lens flare. And I'm going to drop this onto my footage. Now, unfortunately, there's not a good way of doing this within Fusion. I tried a couple different things, wasn't real happy with them, but this method actually worked pretty well. And I want this to animate as much as I can across this entire arch. So I'm going to go to my open effects. Now here's my lens flare. And I think I want to change this to a late afternoon. There it is. It's going to give me a little more powerful of a look. And how do I want to adjust this? Okay, turn down my blend. I'll go with that. I'm going to go to my position. Now, the interesting thing about the lens flare is I cannot position it anywhere on the screen, because not only does it have this main section, it has the flare down here, and it really doesn't let me go below the halfway mark on the screen. So that was a little annoying, but let's go ahead and do some adjustments here. Our XY position, and I'm gonna bring it right down onto there. I think I'm gonna blend it out just a little bit more. Get it right on there. Okay, now I have my X and Y position here, and I'm going to keyframe those. Now I'm going to go to my halfway point. There we go. Go to my halfway point here, thereabouts, and I want it to be pretty much at the halfway point. So make sure I'm on position and bring it across, bring it up to the top there. All right, now I just kind of want to double check how that's going. Well, not really across the top what I want, so I'll go to the halfway point of that. We're just splitting the difference here. And the less keyframes you have, kind of the better off you are. So that's going to cover that one. And now I'll go as much to the end as possible, but I'm not going to be able to go all the way to the end, and I'm going to show you why here. I'm going to adjust my X position. It's not going to really let me do much because it's rendering right now, so I'll let it go ahead and catch up there. All right. So I can bring it down and there we go. All right, we've got it rendered. And I'm gonna try one more time to see if I can get it to blend out. Yep, and now it's gonna work. So I'm gonna keyframe it right here. Actually, I'm gonna keyframe it back here. Then, by the time it gets to the end, we're gonna have it blink out. Then we just have the logo with a nice clean look. So here we go. Let's give it a shot. All right, I think we've got this. Last thing to do, let's add a little beat to it here. And whew. So that was some work to get it done. Sometimes it is best to just let it render and then try doing something else the way you want it, but it can be kind of a real pain in the patootie. I'm going to turn the music off here. So I could work on this timing and get it to be a little cleaner, but you get the idea with how we did all this. Let's go back into Fusion, do a recap. We have our logo onto an image plane, the stars on an image plane. I'm gonna get rid of this, and I'll put the merge over here so we can kind of see what's going on. Okay, this gives us an idea. We have the stars in the background. We have the house in front of that. We have the sphere in front of that with the logo in front of that with our light source that's animated across the whole thing. Whew, that's quite a bit of work for a little logo treatment, but I thought it was going to be fun and show you how to do some of this stuff. I hope you like it. And if you have any questions or comments, feedback, or something that you'd like to see done, be sure and let me know. Well, hopefully that gave you a little insight into what went into creating this. We used 3D objects with a sphere and mapped an image to it. Then we used, a couple different image planes, one for the Milky Way background, one for the house. We faded those in from one to another and added some lighting, a 3D camera, a couple other effects, and then on the edit page added a lens flare. And all together came out pretty nice. He's very, very happy with it, and it's probably going to help some other real estate agents go, wow, that is a pretty cool logo. Maybe we should hire this guy. Well, we'll see if that's the case anyway. Thanks for watching. As always, if you like this type of video, be sure and hit the like button and subscribe. Over 75% of the people who watch these videos never subscribe. Don't know why, it's just the way it is. I want to see more subscribers out there, and we have our 5,000 subscriber giveaway going on. So hopefully you can get in on that. Check out the video. I'll link to it up above so you can make sure you figure out how to make sure that you're entered into the giveaway. So hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I put out a new video. Thanks for watching, everybody. This has been Carrie with Learn DaVinci Resolve, and I will catch you later. Bye-bye.